Shitcase Cinema. On the Shitcase Cinema. Oh, it's the Shitcase Cinema.
Isn't it enough since Hercules rode in your chariot? You've been immortalized.
Okay, so most of you will have heard about this little gem of a film, but probably never seen it, aside from maybe a clip or two on the internet. Now, it's an old movie filmed in 1969, filled to the brim with action, suspense, thrills, comedy, romance, and everything else that you want to see in a movie. And it's tied nicely with a bow in the form of Mr. Universe himself in his very first role, Arnold Strong. Yeah, can you believe they changed Arnie's name because they thought Schwarzenegger was too long? And also perhaps fit him with his Mr. Universe title. Because he's strong. Arnold Strong, yeah, it works. So after some opening titles with cheesy, annoying music, which plays all the time through the film, but I'll comment on this later, we get to see Arnie himself. It's good that we get to see him straight away, as he's the selling point. He's the only reason we're watching this crap. So it's nice that we don't have to wait 20 minutes or so like some films before you see the main star. No prizes for guessing who Arnold Strong plays, but I'll let you work that out for yourself just to keep things interesting. So Arnie's chilling out in Olympus with the other gods, although it looks like a section of Central Park to me. But anyway, he's apparently bored of his life, so prepare yourself, and I mean that, prepare yourself for Arnie's debut speech.
I am tired of the same old faces, the same old things.
Tired or not, you're staying here.
Did you get that? Just rewind it and watch it again and again and again if you didn't. Until you do, which you probably won't.
I am tired of the same old faces, the same old things.
Yeah, well, welcome to real life, Arnold. Life generally is boring and mundane and the same monotonous shit over and over again. It's a pretty impressive speech though, yeah? And that's the selling point of the DVD. Look! Featuring Arnold's real voice. Jesus Christ. Hey, I should not mock it though. I bought it on DVD. Well, no, a friend bought it for me on DVD after I promised him I'd review it, but that's not important.
Oh no, Hercules in New York. Thanks very much.
What's important is that Arnold has defined his father in dramatically high-tension fashion, so he's decided he can't take any more shit from the muscle-bound meathead and shoots him with a thunderbolt, which is a plastic kid's toy, most likely. Boom! There goes our hero, who floats past planes scaring old bags half to death. Nice one! And this next scene tells you how little the budget was for the film. Now basically he's meant to be drowning in the sea, but we don't see it, hell no. Nor do we see Zeus save him. Check this out.
Save Hercules!
Alright, alright. I have done so.
Oh, brilliant. I have done so, it's alright. That's classic. I don't really want to give a run through on the entire story, mainly due to the film lacking any interesting substantial plot that merits a look at, so I'll just focus on the main points involving our lovable Austrian brother. So the most amusing moments are obviously when Arnold speaks, cause his English isn't the best. In the film, I mean, not just in general nowadays. So he fights a bunch of sailors who rescue him at sea because he refuses to work on board, then gets into another fight at the docks. Just check out this brilliant music playing over this exciting battle. It's bloody annoying to say the least. I think it's time to bring Professor Bruce in.
Looking at the fight scenes in Hercules of New York, it's kind of obvious where they got their influence from, and it's kind of a shame that Arnie didn't go over to America maybe 5 years earlier so it could be part of the show that they got their influence from. Let me demonstrate what I mean.
Pow! Whack! Oof! Oof!
Burn it! Of course, he did kind of make up for it by playing Mr. Freeze in Batman and Robin. No, he didn't. That was bollocks.
Now meet Arnie's new friend, Pretzi. And he calls himself this because he sells pretzels down at the docks.
They call me Pretzi because, you see, I sell pretzels on the waterfront there.
Funny bastard. Now he's the star in the movie. He's the pulling power. He's the babe magnet. He's the men of men. He's a fucking loser. Might as well just put Professor Bruce in there in his place. He's not funny. His acting is, and you won't believe me when I say this, his acting is worse than Arnie's, and his character is pretty pointless to the story in general. He starts calling Arnie Herc, as in short for Hercules. Yeah, Arnie plays Hercules, but I'm sure you worked that out earlier on, like I said you should. Herc and Pretzi. May as well just call them penis and sweaty ballsack. So, they get into some altercations with evil taxi drivers. And you know he's evil, look, he's got that beast under his nose. Channels his powers to be all evil. Yet his power is nothing compared to our Herc. Yeah, whatever, Arnie. See you in the next English class. I'd love to see a muscle-bound caveman throwing Professor Bruce around just for my own amusement.
Hi, I'm Johnny Shitcase, and today Professor Bruce is to be absolutely destroyed by a caveman pretending to be Hercules in New York.
Ah, I am so strong. How dare you touch Hercules?
Shit!
Wicked. And again, please.
Ah, yeah, I'm Hercules. I am so strong.
Say, Mr. Achilles, can you do that thing with your tits where Arnie like bounces them about like that? Can you do that?
How dare you touch Hercules?
Not again!
Ah, love that. And I love this. Arnie sees some guys training and thinks that he can do better. But what I love is that when your English isn't too great, you respond by going,
Athletes?
Hey, college guys, yeah.
Hmm.
What do you mean? You think you could do better? What do you mean? These guys happen to be champions.
Ha.
Nobody can beat them.
I am Hercules. I am so strong.
Hold on a second, mate. These weights are actually plastic and 300 grams. That's not much at all.
You insult me. I'm Hercules.
Shit!
Oh, and when demonstrating your javelin skills, it's compulsory to take your shirt off and flex your man boobs. Ooh, one for the ladies there. Oh, guys. Speaking of guys, here's a guy in a bear suit walking around Central Park. It's a bit random. But it all makes perfect sense because the bear escaped from the zoo all by itself. At night time, okay. Then here, we see Arnie in the daytime on a romantic horse and carriage ride, so it makes no sense when the two parties meet in the same scene, and it's night. Sorry, fuck, what am I talking about? It's day. See, this film just mangles and disintegrates your brainwaves. So yeah, it's daytime. And then they have a fight. Now, I can't show you that, though, it's just too silly. But let's hear Arnie do some more talking just for shits and giggles.
I suppose we must miss you.
He didn't want to see me leave. In fact, he was most upset.
Ooh, did he swear? Doesn't say anything about swearing on the back of my DVD, but listen.
Fact.
Okay, here's the bear scene. It's not really worth it. He just runs at it and dances around a bit, and she overreacts to the max, making Nicolas Cage look like an Oscar winner, which he is, how ironic, and Arnie beats the bear to death because he's Hercules. Yep, that bear is now officially
Hercules.
Now sadly, in my opinion, this is a turning point for the film as it loses its comedic touches and basically it just runs out of steam. Even when a scene's got Arnie in it looking stupid and talking bollocks, it's still lost its novelty. Yep, Hercules in New York is complete and utter bullshit by now. And it was before. And it'll continue to be so until the end. He charms this beautiful lady, Zeus and his minions pop up now and then to deliver some pointless, ridiculous exposition, and he becomes a wrestler, but you never get to see him fight. Oh no, these mafia gimps turn up and things begin to turn a little bit sour, and before you know it, Arnie loses his magic powers and becomes a wimp just like you or me. Well, not me. Just check this out, Hercules.
Just getting warmed up, you know. Feel the pump. Do you know what? It's not worth it. I just don't want to just like show off or anything. So there's no point. So just have a beer instead. Yeah.
300-gram weights?
300 grams of pure power, baby.
Hold on. What are you doing with my granddad's urine sample? I need that for a science bit.
Very modest of me. Good boy. So now that Hercules has lost his competition, the Mafia get pissed off and chase him and Prezzi across New York City for some payback. How cool would it be to be walking around the streets and suddenly Arnold Schwarzenegger zooms past on a horse and cart, dressed rather embarrassingly with a guy standing behind him? Yeah, I know his marriage has pretty much fallen to pieces by this point, but don't think he's got to that point just yet. So the big finale of the movie ends with powerless Hercules getting beaten up. What a lame ending. Come on, Zeus, help him. Look into your giant marble and pretend to cast a spell like before. Which he does, cause two guys turn up and kick ass. Arnie gets his powers back, throws giant cans on the baddies, and that's it. Well, not quite, because Arnie suddenly disappears, leaving Prezzi on his own, and he's back on Mount Olympus, dressed like a little girl again, while Prezzi gets shitted right up when his radio becomes possessed by some dude talking from beyond the grave. Puzzled? That's meant to be Arnie talking on the radio, even though it's obviously another voice. Probably the same sad sack who dubbed Arnie over originally, but we don't want that, we want Arnie! That's why I got this DVD in the first place! What a letdown to a shit film.
Herc?
We are friends, you and I. And nothing can take that from us.
It's so bad, obviously. So only watch this for a laugh, nothing more. But maybe play some drinking games so that every time Arnie mispronounces a word, you have a swig and chances are you'll probably need your stomach pumped after about 10 minutes, so just be careful. 1 out of 10.